Hello everyone and welcome to this video. So in this video we will be looking at our first pipeline component, which is data ingestion. So as the name suggests, we'll just be ingesting data into our pipeline. So what is this data and what will we be using it for? So the data that we'll be using is the IMDb movie reviews data set. This data contains nearly 1 million unique movie reviews from over 1,000 different IMDb movies across 17 categories. So we'll go ahead and download this data set. So you can just click the link here and download this data set. Before you can download this data set, however, you need to create an account on IEEE. It's a free account, so just go ahead, create the free account and download this data set. If you also know how to use AWS, you can use the AWS link to download your data set. I have already downloaded the data set onto my computer, into some folders I created. So I'll be running most of my code in all of my code in Jupyter Notebooks. You can, if you have a local installation of Jupyter Notebooks, you can use that. If you don't, you can use Google Colab, but I prefer to have a local installation. If you don't know how to set up Jupyter Notebooks, you can just go to YouTube and just see how do you install Anaconda, and then Anaconda comes with Jupyter Notebooks. You can just go ahead and then use it. I will not be going through how to set up Jupyter Notebooks on your computer. You can find lots of instructions on that on the internet. So let's go ahead and then unzip this data set. So I'm now in my Jupyter Notebook, so I will just say unzip. Then it's dataset.zip, and then I'll run this. It will take a couple of seconds. So you have movie reviews for so many movies. Deadpool. Don't know most of the movies here. Fast and Furious. Yeah, so it's done. The unzipping is done. So before we write our first component, let's just go ahead and then let's just see what's in this reviews data set. So I'm just going to import pandas, and then let's just read one CSV file. So if I go back, so after unzipping, you have two different folders. One is movies per genre and mo reviews per movie role. We are interested in the second folder, which has all the reviews for all the movies. So let's just look at what's in this maybe first CSV file. So just gonna go here, and then it's two, and let's just look at what's in this file, and then I say df.head. So as you can see, so you have the person's username, the rating they gave the movie. So you can see that this person gave this movie Cloverfield Lane a very high rating. So it's probably a positive sentiment. And then there's the date, and then the title, and then the review. So we are interested in this. We are interested in this. We are interested in the review, right? Okay. So, yeah. So the task is given this review, we have to predict whether this rating is positive or not. So, given this, let's just go ahead and then build our first component. So, just going to create a header here, So I'll just say pipeline. Then I'm just going to say sample gen. Let me just change this into markup and then get a nice table of contents over here. Let me just create more cells also. All right. So before we can use TFX, obviously we have to install TFX. So how do we install TFX? We can just install TFX by doing pip install. So pip install TFX. I have already installed TFX on my system, so I'm not going to run this. But if you don't have TFX, so obviously if you're watching this for the first time, I'll assume you don't have TFX. So just go ahead and run pip install. You can run this in your Jupyter notebook, so if you want, go to your command line and run it. That's also fine. So I'll go ahead and delete this. So you can just pause the video when it's done. You can just come back and then continue. All right. So first of all, we would import our first TFX component, which is example gen. Because we are reading in CSV files, the name of the component we would import is CSV example gen. So I'll go ahead and say from tfx.component import CSV sample gen, and then I'll go ahead and run this. Okay, so after it has run, yeah, we can go ahead and then ingest all these data sets. So we would use CSV example gen to ingest all these data sets. So there are about 1,000 CSV files. CSV example gen, we just have to tell CSV example gen the data part, and then it will just automatically ingest all these data sets for us. Okay, so what we have to do next is to say, well, before we ingest, we also have to split our data into training and then validation data. CSV example gen already splits the data for us, but we have to use some configuration to split our data, and that we would need another library. So I'll go ahead and say tfx.proto import example gen pb2. So we'll use this example gen pb2 to define our split configuration. So then let's just go ahead and then now I think I'll just do this on the next line. So we say output and then example gen pb2 dot output. And then we define our split configuration. So what percentage of the data should be trained and what percentage should be test. And then say example gen.pb2.splitconfig and then split. So then I know, right? This is just so many things going on here. So dot split name. So we define our first split configuration and we give it a name. So let's say our name is train, and then we define what percentage of the data should be trained and what percentage of the data should be evaluation or test. So I'll say hash packets. So basically saying about 80% of the data should be trained, and then obviously the remaining 20% should be test. hash buckets equals to 2, right? Okay, so this just performs our split for us. So 80% train and 20% split. Okay, so I plan to make every video at most 10 minutes. So we are past our 10 minutes limit now, and we'll continue with our data ingestion in the next video.